Olympics means to the athlete and to those who wish him well. We'll see a lot more of it tonight. We'll be going to the diving live very shortly, but also the equestrian is still going on at Santa Anita Park. Remember, it's the team show jumping competition. Going to go out there now to, of course, Chris Schenkel.
Package.
They did an interview from Lake Placid with him. So they got a piece they can make out of it.
This is typical of what they've been seeing out there all afternoon. The competition still going on. The United States team very, very strong in this.
I'm out here, Bill Steinkraus, as one of the competitors is out there with about 12 riders remaining. And the battle now is for silver and bronze because the United States team has clinched the gold. First time ever for the United States equestrians to win a team gold since 1912.
The first time in the history of equestrian sport for us, and it's a very, very gratifying experience for the American team that has really worked so tremendously hard. The U.S. team in 1972 lost by only a quarter of a fault to the German team in Munich. And that was as close as the United States team ever got.
Bruno Scolari of Italy, you see the first riders, 8 faults, 4 for the second. And Scolari with only 1 knockdown or 4 penalty points. So for Italy, they have a total now, 3 best lowest scores of the 4-person team, 75.25. They are not in contention for a medal because West Germany and Great Britain and Canada and France are the contenders for the last 2 medals.
That's right. It's a really exciting battle for the silver and the bronze, notwithstanding the fact that the United States team won the gold without the fourth rider even having to ride.
This is the arena in the San Gabriel Mountains, and this is how it happened. Joe Farges, Touch of Class, had 2 clear rounds today. Melanie Smith had 1 for the United States. And of course, Conrad Homefeld had the last, which proved to be the clincher.
And what a classy performance that was, too.
The rider on the course is Guy Creighton of Australia. He is a 34-year-old equestrian riding conclusion.
Yes, Australia is pretty far back also in the standings.
So let's go and see how Joe Farges did it earlier today. Now there is the combination, Joe Farges and Touch of Class, that produced the first clear round here in the first round, helping his team to hold down number 1 after 1 round.
Joe Farges really produced an absolutely dazzling round. I mean, it was a copybook round, as the British call it. He rides in a very, very nice style. The mare jumps in a very, very beautiful style. And it really set, in a way, the character of the whole competition. It proved that it could be done, but it proved that it had to be executed technically very perfectly.
Little 11-year-old mare, the minute she walks into the arena, she knows she's on stage.
She gave that a pretty good bump, and I hope that doesn't mean that she's feeling less generous this afternoon than she did this morning. She was putting out a lot. She was giving her fences quite a lot of air this morning, and I would say she's not doing it this afternoon, Chris. She can sneak over big fence about as neatly as anything you ever saw, but you wouldn't mind it if she were feeling a little bit more ebullient in her spirits than she appears to be right now. So far, so good, however.
Each of the horses must carry 165 pounds.
We have time allowed of 119, not bad for the good riders. She jumps in okay and jumps out okay. All difficult that line here to the water.
That's poetry.
She tried over that. I'd say she gave that a lot of air, and that's comforting. Beats the water perfectly again. Cranks back very well for the Oxer. A little bit close to it behind. She's just a little bit dragging her hind end, but she hasn't hit a fence hard yet.
Oh.
Joe flaps his wings in there because she was long to jump into the three combination.
She had the hardest of rubs or touches, which
coming
don't count.
To the last line, still clear. Boy, what it would mean to Joe to jump two clears in the Olympic Games. Jumps the wall beautifully, steady, steady. Jumps in okay. Very close coming out. My heavens, one fence to go. And she jumped it clear. And that's another clear round for the U.S. team. What a way to start the second round.
Hot. Two clear rounds. Incredible.
You can't say too often, Chris, touch of class isn't the right name, because she's class to her hoof tips.
She retires and won her back on the farm in Indiana. What a lovely, lovely competitor. And what a great rider, Joe Farges of the United States. We'll be back at Santa Anita. Santa Anita, scene of all the equestrian events except cross country, which was at Fairbanks Ranch. It's team jumping today.